This video documents the tunneling process used in the 210 continuation project in Los Angeles County. The first step of the tunneling operation is to set up the horizontal and vertical alignments for the tunnel. The second step of the tunneling operation is the excavation of the launching and receiving pits. The tunnel depth is set at 45 feet. Cal OSHA had to approve the slope configuration and the final excavation of the pits. The next step is to install the rails and the boring machine. A metal pipe is used as a guide for the initial boring operation. The excavated material is removed by a train consisting of two containers that have a 10 cubic meter capacity each. A crane is used to lift each container and dump the material for later disposal. As the boring machine advances, steel ribs and wood lagging are installed every 4 feet. Three pieces of steel ribs and 3 by 6 inch wood pieces are installed between the ribs. In order to maintain adequate ventilation, a tube is installed and the fan is located at the tunnel entrance. As the tunnel digging progresses, a string of lights is hung through the completed sections and then moved as the tunnel moves forward. A resting bench is provided because most of the workers have to take their breaks inside the tunnel. As a safety measure, a board that contains the name of all the tunnel workers is installed at the tunnel entrance. Every person has to indicate if they are entering or leaving the tunnel. The laser beam is used to maintain the tunnel alignment. The boring machine has a target that is constantly checked by the machine operator. The excavated material is carried by a conveyor belt, which dumps the material into the containers. It takes about 20 minutes to fill up both containers. As the tunnel work progresses, more ventilation tubes are added. Once the tunnel is protected with the lagging, the reinforced concrete pipes are installed. These pipes are 12 feet long and weigh 28,000 pounds. In order to move these heavy pipeliners, a pipe carrier is used. This machine is also used to set them in place in the tunnel. The pipe carrier is powered by electricity. Keep the pipes aligned, metal spacers called Dutchmen are installed between the pipe and the lagging. The space between the pipe and the lagging is called annulus. The annulus is later filled with grout. Finally, the boring machine reaches the end of the tunnel. It exits at the receiving pit.
Wow. So this is the actual operation. This is a real operation. That's the way the machine works. It's unbelievable, you know? That's the way it works. Oh yeah, they have light there. Now the machine is really showing, huh?
The receiving pit is protected by a metal cage to protect it from cave-ins.
Mom, two more feet and that's it.
Hey, can I be on it too?
Okay, at this moment, they are calling the guys, the crew, so we can take a picture of them.
The crew celebrates another safe and successful project by gathering for a group photo. The finished tunnel diameter is 7 feet, or 2.1 meters. The total length, 1,440 feet, 540 meters. Construction time of the tunnel was 78 days, with a total cost of $3,132,000.